The Phoenix Suns getting a here for the first time since 1993. They led by a combined 81 points from their big three of Chris Paul, Devin Booker, and DeAndre Ayton. Teams that win game one of the finals, guys, go on to win 72% of the time. So, Mr. Wilbon, what impressed you most about the Phoenix Suns in game one?
You have to start with Chris Paul and just sort of setting the tone. You know, I mean, he and Monty Williams, of course. And this is not new because they've been doing this the entire season. Focus. They don't take plays. I mean, Chris doesn't want them to take plays off it. He's gotten that over to the younger players like DeAndre Ayton. Here's what we do. Here's how we do it. We do it this way all the time. No excuses. Mm-hmm. And they played that way. Yes. They played the way they played in all but two games in the playoffs. And then Chris's performance, I mean, just taking advantage of Milwaukee's, again, you know, I can't trust Milwaukee because I don't even know what they're doing half the time, and particularly defensively. You can't have those forwards. You have to have guards. If you're gonna switch, you have to figure out how to keep those guys out of Chris Paul's way. Because he's going to torch them. I watched the game last night with Isaiah Thomas and with Avery Johnson. And it was so funny, Matt, because they're just explaining what is going to happen every 8 seconds before it happens, every single possession.
That's amazing.
Because they know how they were when confronted with Brook Lopez, with Tucker, with Bobby Portis. You're not stopping Chris Paul. So all of that, I guess, goes into my mix on what just impressed me last night.
Yeah, overall, Chris, very impressive. His first after 16 years finally getting here. But really what surprised me the most is just the poise and the patience that the younger players play with. You could never tell that this young Phoenix team has never been here. They've acted like this is, hey, we're returning here like the Golden State Warriors or something like that. So really impressed with the young players, the way they came out and played. Ayton, 22-19. Book picked his spots. And as Mike said, you know, after Chris's first quarter feeling out the flow of the game, he really started picking and choosing his spots and was just tearing the defense up, but also getting other players involved as well.
Well, look, we all know how smart Chris Paul is, right? So especially with the defensive switching that the Bucks were doing. And they worked on this all year, right? We saw them all season learn to switch right in front of us on the fly because it was what they were criticized for not doing the previous year. But Chris is so smart. He just picked everything apart, especially in the third quarter. So his 32 points, 16 came in that third quarter. And that's really what put the Phoenix Suns on that rocket ship to this win. You played with Chris, obviously. Yes. What is he like on the floor in those moments that he is able to be as surgical as we saw him last night?
Just he's seeing plays before they happen. And as Mike spoke with Isaiah and Avery, great point guards see the play before it happens. They know. So no matter where you're going to hide a Brook Lopez or a Bobby Portis or even a P.J. Tucker on the switch, Chris is going to find them. Mm-hmm. And what I loved about it was obviously he was in his ISOs. No matter if they switched or they dropped, Chris was able to get to his spots and either put pressure by throwing lobs, finding kicking out for threes, or getting to his spots and knocking down that mid-range. And then Devin Booker followed suit. He was coming downhill off the pick and roll all night, getting to his spot and pulling up, fading away a little bit and knocking shots down.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.